you use dictionary. So today, as you said that, which are the storybook you read? That you said that Cinderella and many more things, many more storybook. And other than this, when I ask you that when you come across some of the difficult words, you said that you take help of your teacher, your parent, and many other people. Okay. So if I tell you that even you can help yourself by using the some of the difficult different books to find out the meaning of difficult words, is this magical? Yes, student. Now let's see. Here is one boy, and he is asking for the help. Okay, what he said? So could you show me how to find out what is encourage means, please? Okay. So he having a dictionary. Now he wanted to know the meaning of encourage, but this boy is not able to use the dictionary. It happened to us also. We have the dictionaries at home. Okay, they are quite thick, and we feel like it is very difficult to find out the meaning of one word in so many words, and that's the reason you think that it is comfortable to ask teacher, parent, or any other person other than searching in dictionary. But then searching in dictionary is quite easy. What we need to do, let's see first step by step. Okay. So the very first step is what? First step is to find out the letter from which the word begin. Okay. When you are going to pronounce, what will happen? The very first step is what? Very first step is, what letter does it begin with? Sound it out and then go that the page of the dictionary. What you need to do? You need to pronounce the word first, like the encourage. Encourage word start with the E. Okay. So first find out the sound. Then what letter does it begin with? It begins with letter E. Okay. When we are going to pronounce the word, first pronounce the word. Then second, find out the letter in the page and go to the page like the E. Now, what page it is on? Now, E is in what page? Like E is come after A, B, C, D, E, F, like, okay, in this way. So, you need to go to search this word or search the letter in the dictionary. Okay, now how you are going to search? You are going that all the dictionaries are formed in alphabetical order, okay? Alphabetical order, like from A to B to C to D, and then last is Z. Okay, so after this, first step is what? Look at the next letter. If you are not sure, have a book at the EN word until you find the word encourage. Okay, now in the first step, what you need to do? You need to search for the second letter, like after E, like the many more words start with the letter E. Now, what you're going to do? You're going to search each and every letter, okay? Each and every word? No. What you need to do? You need to look for the second letter. Like after E, in the pages, like the 10 pages are allotted for the words, difficult words starting with letter E. Okay? Suppose, imagine, 10 pages are allotted in one dictionary to give the meaning of all difficult words starting with letter E. E से शुरू होने वाले जितने भी डिफिकल्ट वर्ड है उनको 10 पेज में बताया गया है. सो यू आर गोइंग टू सर्च ऑल 10 पेजेस? नो. दैट इन दैट आल्सो फ्रॉम लेटर ई इट इज स्टार्टेड विद ई ए ई बी ई सी ई डी इन दिस वे. ओके. सो व्हेन इट विल कम टू द पेज ऑफ ई एन इन दैट पेज यू नीड टू सर्च फॉर द वर्ड एनकरेज. लाइक हियर you can see that the encourage meaning is written in the dictionary, like to contribute or to motivate. Okay, student, these are the steps of finding the words, difficult words in the dictionary. The very first one is to pronounce the word and identify from which letter it is starting. Then next, searching for the letter. Okay, then at what page that letter is. And the last, finding the next letter after the main word. Okay. Let's see what is mean by dictionary. Definition of dictionary. A dictionary is a reference book that lists the word in alphabetical order. What is dictionary? Dictionary is a reference book that lists the word in alphabetical order. Okay. Now, student, it is very necessary to know the meaning of dictionary. I request you all to kindly note down the meaning of this word dictionary. Okay? So, be ready with your notebook. And start writing. We'll wait for 1 minute more and then we will proceed with. Okay, now as we have already written the meaning of dictionary, now what dictionary help us from that tradition? It gives us meaning. How dictionary help us? Dictionary, it gives meaning and the other details of the listed words. Each listed word is called as entry word. Now children, you know there are the many words which is there inside the dictionary. So all the words which is listed in the dictionary are called as entry word. What it is called as? It is called as entry words. The whatever word you see in the dictionary, that is small, small words, it's called as entry words. And what this entry words gives us? It gives us the meaning. Okay, meaning of the words. Okay, so dictionary help us to know the meaning and the details of the word listed. Each listed word is called as entry word. Okay, now let us see what are the things we find in the dictionary. Now, what are the things we find in the dictionary? We find the first of all meaning. Okay, dictionary tell us what word means. Okay, like the motivate means encourage. Okay, so dictionaries show us how a word spell. Okay, how the word spell. Now then, how the word pronounce. Okay, the very first one is meaning, then spell, then pronunciation, and then same word. Okay, now other than, there are some words which are very difficult to keep in mind and remember for a long time. So for this, dictionary also help us to know the meaning of alternative word. Okay, alternative word which having a same meaning. Okay, now example, even dictionary gives us example. It has the examples of the word that how to use in the sentence. Okay, now next is word phrases related to that. Now dictionary point out the different meanings of words in have the same spelling. Now you know about the homograph. Homograph are the words which are having the same spelling, but the meaning is different. Like the bat, bat, both having the same spelling, but one bat means a equipment to play the cricket, and the second bat means a mammal. Okay, so these are the both having the same spelling, but the meaning is different. So even the dictionary points the different meaning of a word which have the same spelling. Now dictionary also tell us the grammatical class of word which belongs, like ed form, verb first form, second form. It is also mentioned in the dictionary. Now children, now you all are aware about meaning of dictionary, how to use dictionary, and also that what are the things we can find in the dictionary. It is very simple to keep in mind: meaning, spelling, pronunciation, and then form of word, and then example related to it, same word having the same spelling, and grammatical class. These five things we can learn, or we can learn from the dictionary, or we can use the dictionary for these five things. Okay, now there are the different types of dictionary. Okay, now what are the different types of dictionary? Like first of all children dictionary, and then after pronunciation dictionary, after that synonyms dictionary, then human body like the encyclopedia, and last is your internet dictionary. Okay, so one by one we are going to see this all type of dictionary. Let's have a look towards the each type. First of all, children dictionary. Now what is children dictionary, student? From the name itself you can justify that this word is children dictionary is for specially designed for the children. Now some dictionaries are designed especially for children. They include only a few thousand words, but there are many pictures, diagram, and children in the children dictionary. There may also be words, game, puzzle, and joke based on the meaning of the use of word. Now see, this is an example of children dictionary. If you can see close towards this each page, you can see lot of pictures are there. Okay, lot of pictures are there, like the wrapper. Okay, other than this boy is doing something with the help of picture. What happened with the help of picture? All these hard words are explained so that the children can understand in a better way, and they can be remember the same thing for a long time. Okay, so what is the specialty of children dictionary? Okay student, what is the specialty of children dictionary? Specialty of children dictionary is what? speciality of children dictionary is it content lot of picture. Okay, it content lot of picture to identify or to remember the meaning for a long time, and it is specially designed for the children. Okay, now next type of dictionary is pronouncing dictionary. Now pronouncing dictionary is a dictionary provide only the pronunciation of word. It is showed with the help of special symbols. Now these dictionaries are available in two form, like in the video form, audio form, and also in a form of book. Okay, so this dictionary is specially designed. It contains only pronunciation, how to pronounce the word. Sometimes student, you face difficulty to just pronounce the word. Okay, you are aware about the meaning, but you face difficulty to pronounce the word, okay, in a proper way. For this pronouncing dictionary, like the Cambridge English pronouncing dictionaries are there. Okay, this dictionary help us to know the pronunciation of word with the help of special symbols. Okay, now next is synonyms dictionary. Now synonyms dictionary is a dictionary which gives us meaning of the same word or the alternative word. As I told you that this synonyms means what? The meaning, the word which having a same meaning. So admit, confess, alike means same, okay, assist means help, awful much terrible, begin with start, big with large. Okay, so this dictionary contains the word and the other word which having the same meaning. So that's why it is called as synonyms dictionary. Okay student, now next type of dictionary is what? Next type of dictionary is visual dictionary. What it is? Visual dictionary. Now the visual dictionary don't have the meaning of the word. Okay, this dictionary only contain the pictures and very less words, like labeling, like parts of tree. Okay, so parts of tree like the trunk, branches, leaf, flower, fruit. Okay, so it going to be label each and every part of the tree. So this kind of dictionaries are known as visual dictionary. Let's see, some bun dictionaries only a visual or the pictures. They do not have an explain the meaning in the words, as the visual dictionaries speak for themselves. They may be in the form of photographs, diagram, and hand drawn pictures. They all label. See the simple visual given along. In the same way, even a complicated machine or the systems are made simple and visual dictionary. So the visual dictionaries are the dictionaries which help us to understand the diagram in a better way. It contains the picture, and with the help of picture, all the difficult parts of the machine or the parts of the tree or the parts of the flower or the parts of the bodies are mentioned. So this kind of dictionary is having a picture and very less word. There is no explanation of the particular word, because that the picture itself describes the same. Okay students, so these are the last, second, the third type of dictionary. Now let's see the next one. Okay, so before moving next, I am going to ask you a few questions based on the previous type of dictionary. So be ready for it, and then we will proceed to see the next one. Okay students, now the children, see the next is visual dictionary's picture. As I told you, visual dictionary contains a lot of picture, and with the help of diagram itself, it is the meaning of word is explained. There are the many words, okay, which we are not understand with the help of explanation of it, but with the help of picture we understand in a better way. So visual dictionary contains a lot of picture, and with the help of picture itself, the meaning of word is explained. Next is encyclopedic dictionary. Now what is encyclopedic? Many more time student, we think that encyclopedia is a type of book, it's not a dictionary, but exactly encyclopedic dictionaries are a type of dictionary. Encyclopedias are the book that give a lot of information about a great number of topic. So because of that, this type of dictionaries are very thick, okay, and it contained the information about many more things, like that the 50 pages will be allotted for the solar system, then 50 pages allotted for the give information about the parts of body. Okay, now 50 pages will be given for the wild animals, and then 50 pages will be given for the aquatic animals. So there are the n number of topics are covered in the encyclopedias. Okay, so it's called the encyclopedic dictionary too. Give a lot of that the encyclopedic dictionary to give a lot more information about the most of the word they contained. Okay, so these dictionaries are usually quite thick and contained many more words than the smaller dictionaries. Okay, now as the encyclopedia having a lot of information, in the same way, encyclopedic dictionary also contain a lot of information about the different meaning of the different words. Okay, like see, here in this picture you can see that the encyclopedic dictionaries are contain very less pictures, but it contain the meaning of lot of words. Okay, the words which is related to the many more things, and that's why these books are very thick in a size, and that's the reason they are in called as encyclopedic dictionary. As the encyclopedias are the book, okay, which gives information about the many more topics, in the same way encyclopedic dictionaries are the dictionaries which gives contains the word related to the many more things which are there around us. We are words which we not use in our day to day life, but still it contains the meaning of this word. Okay, now let's see the next type of dictionary. Okay, that the dictionary which we all use in nowadays, it is difficult to find out and search, and it is somewhat the time consuming to open the dictionary and find out the meaning. But nowadays, due to internet and Google, it is very easy to identify the meaning or to search for the meaning of the difficult words, like from the dictionary.com, Cambridge Dictionary, and free online dictionary. These are the some of the website which gives us the meaning, correct meaning of the words. If you go to the Google and simply type words which you want to know, meaning of the word which you want to know, it will give you in a fraction of second. So nowadays, most of the people use this kind of dictionary because it is easy and it is very less time consuming. Within a fraction of second, you get the meaning of the word. Okay, so children, these all dictionaries help us to know the meaning. But you know that if you are going to use Google, okay, you will get the meaning of only word which you want to know. But if you are going to use this kind of any children dictionary or encyclopedic dictionary or visual dictionary, at the same time you will look upon the so many words, and that will surely help you to just increase your vocabulary and also list some of the new words in your mind. ठीक है, अगर आप गूगल यूज करोगे तो आपको उसी चीज का मीनिंग पता चलेगा जो आप सर्च कर रहे हो. बट अगर आप डिक्शनरी में ढूंढोगे तो आप वो वर्ड ढूंढते ढूंढते बहुत सारे वर्ड्स आपको दिखाई देंगे और आपको उनके बारे में भी पता चल जाएगा. सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द बेनिफिट टू यूज द डिक्शनरी इन डे टू डे लाइफ. सो वी हैव सीन चिल्ड्रन डिक्शनरी, देन प्रोनाउंसिंग डिक्शनरी, देन सिनोनिम्स डिक्शनरी, देन विजुअल डिक्शनरी, एंड एट द एंड इनसाइक्लोपीडिक dictionary, and at the end we have seen that the online dictionary which are available in internet. Okay, so these are the some types of dictionary. All dictionary help us to know the meaning of difficult words. Okay students, is it clear?